Welcome back to the NutraMedical Report. And we have quite a bit of information to cover today. Major issues going on in terms of what's happening with Ukraine. Lots of issues coming up. I will be Skyping into the conference coming up on the 22nd and 23rd in Austin, Texas. The FukushimaSolutions.com. I hear a bit of an echo there. So, Harley, we have lots of major stuff going on, and I know that Linda LaRouche has had some input in the Russian television. Obviously, the moves that are going on back and forth right now are bringing the world to the brink of a major conflict, and it needs to have cooler heads prevail.
Well, you're right. Lyndon LaRouche has been all over the Russian television because he's one of the few people in the United States who's telling the truth about how insane Obama is in pushing toward a confrontation with Russia.
Right.
Now, I might add that in Europe, there's now beginning to be much more coverage of the nature of the coup that was carried out by NATO on behalf of the bankers to throw out the elected government of Ukraine and put in a government that has two postures to it. One, IMF fascist austerity. They already cut the pensions of the Ukrainian people by 50%, this new government. And number two, to allow Ukraine to serve as a forward basing for NATO against Russia. But what LaRouche has said in the last couple of days is this is not about something 2 or 5 or 7 years from now. We're actually on the verge of war because of this. Now, I want to add, there's, as I was saying, in Europe, the German press, because the Germans are very close to the situation, both in terms of wanting to continue to trade with Russia, but also not wanting to be incinerated. And the former German Chancellor Schroeder came out the other day saying that the crisis was not caused by Putin, but by the European Union and the United States, which is absolutely true.
Yeah, they continued to gobble up territory. 2 years ago, when the Russians moved into Georgia, it was after the NATO attempted to make Georgia another NATO nation. It doesn't even make sense. NATO is supposed to oppose the so-called Soviet Empire. And what they're doing is encircling Russia, who's now rebuilding their military armaments in response to us actually showing these aggressive stances in terms of our financial approach, which caused the crash of the Russian economy 25 years ago.
Well, now let me tell you the other thing that's happening.
And the military
today,
posture to actually encircle Russia and China. I mean, Putin had no choice. I mean, what was he going to do? I mean, in a drunken stupor, Khrushchev in 1954 gave away Sevastopol and the Crimea. But it's been in the Russian Empire for 250 plus years. So this idea that they don't have a reason to be there, especially when they're being gobbled up, and then they're going to put these forward-placed missile silos right on the Russian border. I mean, this is like taking a cage with a big Russian bear inside the cage and sticking a stick in the cage and rattling it back and forth to this angry, hungry bear. It's not smart.
And then complaining when the bear growls.
Right. When the bear growls, it said, bad bear. It's like, no, it's a normal bear. You're aggravating the bear. Get back from
the cage. Well, let me fill out the picture, because today is a very significant day. In the Washington Times today, in their print edition and their online edition, there's an ad from Lyndon LaRouche called J'accuse, which is a reference to the famous Emile Zola attack on the French elites who prosecuted Captain Alfred Dreyfus, which was part of a destruction of the French general staff, which was necessary for the British to get the French on their side for World War One. And Zola attacked the operation with a famous leaflet called J'accuse, I accuse. Lynn put out a full-page ad in the Washington Times today accusing Obama of pushing for nuclear war, imposing fascism in the United States, a dictatorship, and ripping up the Constitution. Now, that ad appeared today. Who is Obama meeting today? Yatsenyuk, the so-called new president of Ukraine, who was installed by Victoria Nuland of the State Department and Obama. And Yatsenyuk's mission was to destroy any remnant of the old government, which they did with armed might, as they had gunmen in the parliament. and secondly, to introduce International Monetary Fund austerity measures on Ukraine. And when Yatsenyuk came in, he said, look, this government is on a suicide mission because we're going to do things that are going to cause us to be hated. And he's absolutely right. Why are they doing this? Because Ukraine owes $15 billion to the Western banks. And part of the deal that Putin made with Ukraine was that he would loan them $15 billion, but it would be to invest in Ukraine. Instead, the EU is saying, we'll come up with the $15 billion. But it has to go right through your accounts to the European banks. Banks in Austria, Germany, France, and Britain. And secondly, in return for us magnanimously bailing out the banks for you, you're going to get $15 billion extra debt on your books. And to cover that, you're going to have to cut spending on everything.
What I hear also, they collateralized all the real assets in the Ukraine. They also, I heard... pretty significant rumors, and I think they're probably true, that they actually parked the gold, 40 containers of gold, and flew it out of Ukraine just during last week.
Well, the other thing is that the person who they're pushing to be the replacement for Yanukovych, this woman Yulia Tymoshenko, was a bigger crook than Yanukovych. In fact, she was in prison, but she's a billionaire. She was part of the Al Gore operation that in the 90s looted Ukraine. She's known as the gas princess in Ukraine for her role in jacking up the gas prices so people in Ukraine went cold in the winter. So what we're seeing is very simple. Forget everything else. It's a provocation of Russia putting people who proclaim their loyalty to the tradition of Ukrainian Nazis from World War II, to put them in power, to crush the people of Ukraine, and to serve as a provocation to Russia. And I don't know if you saw on the Sunday talk shows, Bill, but you had James Baker III, you had, who was the other one, Cheney, basically saying Obama's soft, he should be provoking Russia more. William Hague, the defense minister or the foreign minister of Britain, saying the same thing. And their idiot energy minister said, well, if we have a war, it will be a little tough because gas prices might go up, but otherwise we'll survive. What the hell is he talking about? If there's a war with Russia, you think they're going to fight a conventional war over Ukraine?
No. In fact, Russia's entire policy in the past 40 years is that they knew they couldn't match the entire giant budget of the United States and Western powers. So they had the best physicists on Earth design weapon systems that, number one, will defend them, allow them to attack and destroy all our cities, allow them to attack and destroy and turn our blue water navy into trash on the ocean surface or sunk at the bottom, and to completely destroy any jet aircraft or missiles coming into Russian or Soviet airspace, because I don't believe the Soviet Union ever really went away. We did an economic destruction plot 25 years ago on the Soviet Union, and it was succeeded. It blew the country apiece purposely. They actually, destroyed the economy on purpose. The Western powers did.
And so totally intentional.
Totally intentional. And people need to know, they've even made movies on this. What people need to understand is that Russia has been continuously aggravated and destroyed by the British powers and the banks since the destruction of the Tsar and Tsarina and the setting up of the pogroms across the Pale of Poland and Russia, etc., killing the Russian Orthodox monks and the rabbis.
Well, and when we come back from the break, we should talk about Al Gore's role in destroying Russia.
Yeah, Igor, I call him Igor. we need to know real history here, people out there. What's going on is we have a thrust for power, to have one power control, is to say one ring to control them all, is what we're trying to see here. And the banks are doing it. This letter is quite amazing. Lacuse, Lyndon's quite a character, isn't he? I mean, brilliant to actually put this out and make these statements. Who's actually going to carry it out, though? I mean, has Congress got enough guts to actually start the, you know, either impeach Obama or hold your hats? We're heading toward World War III. I mean, that's where I see this.
Well, here's the basic situation on that. What Lynn has said is that you've got people in the Congress in both parties who know that Obama has committed impeachable acts.
Right.
Some of them are beginning to figure out that it's not just impeachable acts, but he's doing things that endanger the nation in a way that's never been endangered before, the danger of a thermonuclear war. Now, what's happening is we're seeing what I think I reported to you last week. I call them baby steps, that you have some Democrats inching away from Obama. In other words, they're not jumping away, or they're not saying, I'm finished with Obama, but they're saying, I'd rather not have Obama campaign for me. I really don't like the Affordable Care Act. You know, people like Joe Manchin in West Virginia has probably taken the biggest step among Democrats, but Begich in Alaska, Mark Pryor in Arkansas, Mary Landrieu in Louisiana. Now, I'm not holding them up as senators of virtue. I'm just saying that they know that sticking with Obama is a curse of death for them in the upcoming 2014 elections. Right. Now, something happened in the last couple of days, which is causing a real rupture with Democrats, which is the report that a Senate Intelligence Committee staff grouping, which was looking into torture, looking into what the CIA did under the Bush-Cheney years and continuing into the first couple of years of Obama, they were preparing a mammoth report to show how gross the violations were, how big the lying was when people from the CIA said there's no torture, when Bush said it, Cheney said it, Obama said it. This committee got documents probably from CIA whistleblowers and others that will blow the lid off the whole thing and will go right into the lap of Obama's key collaborator, John Brennan. So what happened? The CIA started spying on the Senate Intelligence Committee staffers. And it got so intense that Dianne Feinstein, who up to this point has been an apologist for the NSA, an apologist for Obama, she went to the Senate floor yesterday and said, this is intolerable.
Yeah.
Now, two senators...
That takes a lot to get Dianne Feinstein to turn on them like that. I mean, obviously, she realized that she was being worked as well.
Well, what she realized is that her staffers were going to abandon her. These are people that have worked for her and with her for years. This is their job. They put this together, and their careers and lives possibly are threatened by the CIA. So right. If Feinstein wanted to have a staff, she had to speak up. So I don't think this is particularly a sign of virtue on her part.
No, self-preservation is what it is.
Well, and then you have two senators who are a little bit more honest, Democratic Senator Wyden from Oregon and Mark Udall from Colorado. Now, Wyden and Udall had been blowing a whistle for a while saying, look, we've got to see these classified documents from the NSA because there's a violation of the law going on here. And finally, the administration said, okay, we'll let you see them, and they saw them, and that was after Snowden blew the whistle. So right. Now you've got Democrats who know that Obama not only continued the Bush policies, but his administration lied about it. And Obama knew that his buddy Brennan sicked the CIA on the Senate staffers.
Well, now, and also, by the way, the renditions have increased under Obama, and the torture has increased under Obama, and this is all in all these different countries all over the world, including places like Turkey and awful places where they actually were doing torture. And before the Syrian crisis, they were even renditioning people to Syria to be tortured there.
Now, the important thing is that this is another example of a violation of the separation of powers, that the executive using the CIA, you know, the CIA charter says it's illegal for the CIA to operate in the United States,
right.
But it was doing it for years, and then you remember the Church Committee in the 1970s, where they reasserted by law that the CIA has no authority to ever operate on U.S. soil. And so now you have clear evidence that this was a violation of U.S. law, a violation of separation of powers, done by the CIA with the full knowledge of President Obama. And so this is another inducement for impeachment.
I think they're actually talking about it now because I think that there are a number of situations now where congressmen are finally getting ready to say, we're ready to actually put forward the action. Now, that also increases the chances that Obama, being as devious as he is, the people behind him, doing something like a false flag or something catastrophic that'll really throw the nation
into a state.
Well,
this is the war threat with Russia. That's what the war threat with Russia is. Look, they don't want to risk. See, the plan, here's the problem. Plan A is Russia surrenders and joins the global financial system, the global order.
Right.
There is no plan B. If Russia doesn't submit, they intend to destroy Russia, even if it means nuclear war. Now, that's the first problem. Now, there's one other thing that's happening today that just finished right now, which is that two congressmen, one from North Carolina, Walter Jones, and a Republican, and a Democrat from Massachusetts named Lynch, held a press conference at the National Press Club with the family members, the leaders of the family members of 9/11 victims, and with former U.S. Senator Bob Graham, a Democrat, who has been campaigning along with LaRouche to have the 28 pages on the Saudis from the congressional special investigation into 9/11 released publicly. Obama, when he came into office, said he would consider it, and then, of course, he never did, because Brennan is partly is tied to the Saudis. Obama's going to Saudi Arabia next month. So this press conference is going to be explosive, because now you have Republicans and Democrats linking up with the members of the families of the victims of 9/11, along with the senator who oversaw the report, which has been classified and has not been seen since it was produced. Is Obama going to continue to cover this up when it's clear that the Saudis were involved in 9/11? So this is, you know, you put these things together, the spying on the Senate Intelligence Committee, the support for Nazis in Ukraine, the support for jihadis in Syria, and then the protection of the Saudis, and then the protection of the too big to fail bankers who are a bunch of criminals and swindlers. This Obama is nothing but a criminal and swindler himself who's been deployed by these bankers and the Queen of England to destroy the United States. So we have to be more loud and more aggressive than ever to get this out.
Absolutely. Remarkable update and information. We'll be back in a moment with Harley Schlanger, LaRouche Foundation, LaRouchePAC.com, the Executive Intelligence Review, LaRouchePUB.com. We'll post up all the links so you can look at the articles and videos yourself, get informed, and take action. Back in a moment. Yeah, I've got all three articles here. Carly mentioned something pretty significant last Thursday, and I know about this, but I want you to expand on it. I call it Obama, that's his name now, or the Abomination, either one works, took to himself dictatorial powers. We are in a state of national emergency as we speak. Without any specific real reason for it, Obama's decided we're in a national emergency. He has the right and power now to jail anybody or to execute anybody at will without Congress. That's very scary. We have the rise of a new Caesar, a new emperor.
Well, he issued a declaration of national emergency, in which he said, as President of the United States, under the authorities vested in him by the Constitution, he has declared a state of national emergency over the Russian moves in the Crimea. Now, he said that we are supporting the legitimate government of Ukraine. Now, what Lyndon LaRouche said is that that's a complete lie. There is no legitimate government of Ukraine. This is a coup, a group of people who took over the government of Ukraine. And by the way, Sergei Lavrov, the Russian foreign minister, made an interesting point. You remember when the Morsi regime was overthrown in Egypt because Morsi, who was tied to the Muslim Brotherhood and the Obama crowd, was going for a dictatorship in Egypt, and the people of Egypt overthrew them. Right. And at that point, McCain and others said we shouldn't give any aid to the people who came to power, because under U.S. law, and when there's a coup, you cannot give money. Now, meanwhile, John Kerry and others are trying to get $1 billion out of the Congress to give to the coup makers in Ukraine. And Lavrov said, well, that's a violation of U.S. law. And then he said, but I don't think people in the U.S. care that much in the government. Now, what LaRouche said on this national emergency is that, number one, there's no evidence that shows that this is a legitimate government in Kiev. It was a coup carried out by the EU, by the United States, that put military forces with Nazi ties in power.
Right.
Number two, there's no evidence that Russia violated any treaty agreements, because the Russians already had a treaty which allowed right. them to station up to 25,000 troops in Crimea to man their port in Sevastopol.
Right.
Number three, Putin said he acted based on request by the legitimate government of Crimea because of their fear that these armed Nazis were going to come in and put them under control, under the power of the military grouping that took control in Kiev. So every point, point by point by point in the national emergency declaration was a lie. And so what LaRouche said is that this demonstrates the nature of Obama, grabbing power based on lies to provoke a situation which is putting us on the brink of war with Russia. And
we have more than one flashpoint, too, now. We have three flashpoints. We have Syria, Iran, now Ukraine. This is increasing the chances of a miscalculation starting a war, dramatically increases it.
Well, now, there's one other thing that you know about, but probably most of your listeners don't, which is that there's been a reorientation in strategic military thinking in the last years, which goes back to something that LaRouche worked on with Ronald Reagan, which was the Strategic Defense Initiative, but the idea that if both sides possess this capability to knock out each other's missiles, then you eliminate the advantage of launching a first strike, and you also put an end to the idea of mutual and assured destruction. So the idea was that both sides would develop these capabilities, and then neither side would have an advantage, and then you could actually move into an era without war. Now, instead, when the Russians, and this was the Soviet Union, turned down Reagan's offer, and then they collapsed, the idea was to break up the Soviet Union and subordinate Russia to the power of the banks. And they almost did it. This was the Gore-Chernomyrdin Commission that privatized everything, created the billionaire oligarchs in Russia,
right.
Who were in cahoots with bankers in London and New York City.
Right, that's where the money flowed through. It flowed through the Russian banks from Western banks to make them instant billionaires and make these oligarchs beholden to the West.
And many of the oligarchs were former KGB agents who, under Yeltsin, got deals through Viktor Chernomyrdin, who was Yeltsin's prime minister, who had a relationship with Al Gore. Now, when Yeltsin fell and Putin came in, Putin ended that. He said, we're not going to open our country to looting. We're going to build up our country based on using the raw materials. And one of the things Putin was very concerned about was the demographic collapse of Russia. And this year, for the first time since the collapse of communism, Russia's birth rate exceeded its death rate. So he's turned the country around on that.
He's actually got a National Conception Day now. He tells everyone to go home and have fun, make babies.
Yeah, now here's to go back to the military point, the evil utopians of the Paul Wolfowitz types and the Doug Feith types and the Robert Kagan types. Robert Kagan is a neocon who's the husband of Victoria Nuland. Here you have neocons working together with what are called LIMPs, liberal imperialists, like Susan Rice, the CIA or the NSA director, Samantha Power, the UN ambassador. This is the Soros crowd and the neocons working together. And their military side came up with what they called a strategy for first strike attack, that we would decide when Russia was about to attack us, and instead we would preempt that, and then we would use missile defense to protect against a Russian response. Now, this is clinically insane. Anyone who believes this should be put in a straitjacket and given very humane care, but they should be given care because they're crazy. The idea that you could launch a nuclear war and limit it is crazy. Now, the Russians know that's the new U.S. strategy, so what's their strategy? To try and deploy submarine-based capabilities in conjunction with intercontinental missiles so that they could preempt it with their own first strike. Now, Putin knows that Russia's behind still on the technology on this, and he has no desire to get into this kind of war. But this is what was pushed by Bush and Cheney, and this is what's being pushed by Obama.
Right, and so and the reason is they know this Tier 1 science that America possesses. That gate will close in the next 10 or 15 years. And so they see the neocons think they have a window to destroy Russia and China, which is also decades behind, and subjugate them primarily to the banking structure they want for a new world order.
Exactly, exactly. And not only that, but they believe that it is a short window, but they also believe that by doing it now, they could win a nuclear war if they had to.
Let me explain some of the things. These are classified information, by the way. America has not only the kinetic system, which when I went down on July 10th, 1994, as Q-level security clearance, which is the same level as the president. One of the first things they did is brought us to a briefing room and a media theater that had full media of people that were actually from Disney Corporation. And they had videos there to explain theater air defense. And they gave a 45-minute presentation on that alone on video, on the big giant screen, digital screen. And they showed that theater air defense was far more advanced than the Patriot system. In fact, they didn't even have one built when they offered the Patriot system to the Israelis when they went into the Gulf War I. They declared Gulf War I in August, and they didn't go into February. And the reason why in 1991 is they had to go backward in their engineering because theater air defense is a kinetic system, hit a missile with a missile. But they had another level system that was basically a Tesla system, that anything that went through the upper atmosphere would immediately be annihilated from space. They had kinetic weapons as well and space-based weapons platforms and energy-directed weapons that can be launched from jets and from space-based satellites as well. They hit the object with a plasma beam at the speed of light. So, yeah, we have a lead now, and that's why these maniacs think war is a winnable thing, and it's not. Cut off with all this so much bad news, my brain is spinning like a bad tune in your head. Welcome back, and Harley, the hour is late. What do we do to get people activated to scream to the top of their lungs to their congressmen they have to start impeachment? We need to have this situation resolved very quickly, because I think the Russians will pull it. I think that Putin is not one to delay anymore, and that if there's any military actions by Poland, it'll pull all the other countries in, or sanctions by Europe or America that are even worse. All Russia has to do is say, we in Russia and the BRICS nations are not going to deal with the dollar anymore. And there's so much high leverage now, the dollar will crash like a sack of bricks. And what will happen is the entire world economy will just go to a screeching halt. There will be
This is one of these cases where the United States is the aggressor, but we've got a lot of lot to hide as well in terms of our own collapsed economy. Look, let me make a couple of points, because we've been discussing this for the last 45 minutes, and I think if people get anything out of this, what they should realize is that we're on the verge of war with Russia, which would be a nuclear war. There's no reason for it except for the fact that we have an insane person in the White House. Secondly, the Congress, even though they've been cowards, corrupt, gutless, immoral all along, many of them are beginning to realize that their inaction is threatening not only the nation, but themselves and their families. They can't even protect their own corruption. Their corrupt deals are gone. So what we've got to do, and we've been mobilizing this last 10 days with this kind of approach, we've been getting everyone who talks with us, who works with our offices around the country, who's part of the Keisha campaign. We now have a Senate, a congressional race in Northern California in Nancy Pelosi's district to throw her out. Wherever we have an office, we're telling people, call us and coordinate with us, calling into the Congress, and do it over and over and over, and get more people. If everyone who makes a call gets five others to make calls, we'll convince these cowards in Congress that they should be more scared of their constituents than they are of getting their masters angry. And so I want to give a number where people can call and find out. You can tell us who your congressman is, and we can let you know what's going on in that district and if we have other people working on it, because we've got to have this mobilization now. So the number to call is 800-922-2907. That's Impeachment Central. We're coordinating the impeachment of Obama, which includes, as I said, a very big ad today in the Washington Times, the second biggest paper in Washington, D.C., an ad calling for the impeachment of Obama. So the number again for Impeachment Central is 800-922-2907. And when you call that number, tell them you heard about this on Bill Deagle's show, the Nutramedical Hour, and that you want to be a part of the impeachment campaign to throw Obama out of office before he gets us all killed. So again, the number, and it's toll-free for you, it doesn't cost you a penny, 800-922-2907. And if you do want to talk to me personally, you can tell the person you call that you want to talk to me. I've called people back who call in from this program, because this, I'm dead serious about this. We face nuclear war in the immediate period ahead if we don't remove Obama. But he's removable. He's impeachable.
Here's a little twist that I see on this as well. Behind the scenes, there's a lot of what I call dirty dialectic going on with Russia and with China. And one of the scenarios, I mentioned it could be space debris or a meteor hit the Malaysian aircraft, but it also, I heard also from a very good source today, that there were a number of scientists from China that were working on supercomputers in China, and it could well be that this aircraft was taken over, because we'd have Global Hawk in every Boeing aerospace jet for the past 30-some years that can actually take over the control of the jet, and it was changed directions by the Malaysian Air Force. Notice this jet changing direction going over the Malaysian Peninsula. So behind the scenes, not only are there overt things like deploying missile defense systems right in Poland and Moldova, but, you know, offering NATO membership to Georgia and Ukraine, this is a direct provocation. And you have a retooled Russian military that basically is expanding to 100 new bases, going around to a dozen new countries to actually set up naval bases in places like Venezuela and Cuba and elsewhere, and expand them dramatically. They don't want to do this when they have a faltering economy and a single economy based on oil. They want to do this because they know they're at risk. They're being surrounded and crushed. And even with the emerging empire of China, they know they're completely surrounded with the Asian nations that are tied directly to America, South Korea, Taiwan, and Japan. And Japan is armed to the teeth with nuclear weapons. Don't believe the lies that they don't have nukes. They got probably, besides the Russian RD-80 rocket systems, the best space delivery system rockets other than the Ariane in Europe in the world. And the Japanese can deliver a warhead as well as they can deliver a satellite watching your vines grow in your orchard.
But Dr. Bill, let me tell you, there's another tendency going on, which is that the Japanese have never been known for their principles. And if they think the U.S.-British Empire is going down, they could switch sides. The South Koreans are already coordinating much more with the Chinese. Now, the point here is that this is not anti-Americanism, what I'm talking about. I'm talking about the real pro-American tendency is to get Obama out because he goes against the American system, against the American tradition. And so we have the potential to put together a world of sovereign nation states collaborating on these kinds of economic principles to destroy the global bankers, the globalists, to put them out of business, to use Glass-Steagall. The fact that we just had a primary election in Texas where Keisha Rogers got into a runoff against a hand-picked candidate of the Democratic Party who couldn't even get 50% of the vote despite spending $3.5 million to less than $30,000 for Keisha. And Keisha, who's a LaRouche Democrat, her whole campaign was impeach Obama to stop the danger of war. And now we have, between now and May 27th, the chance to win that nomination. But the way we're going to do it is we're going to mobilize now to escalate the mobilization for impeachment. And again, the number for Impeach Obama Central is 800-922-2907.
And by the way, this has to be bipartisan. Once it gets rocking and rolling, a number of Democrats who are inching away like a snail, they'll start running from a burning building of the Obama administration.
Well, they already know they're not going to get reelected if they continue to support Obama.
Right. Well, and they should realize they're only months away from the midterm elections.
Yeah.
And the same with the Republicans that have been gutless over this. And John Bonner should be ashamed of himself collaborating behind the scenes for Obamacare, et cetera. Obamacare needs to be repealed. It's just a complete scam. We need to have a better foreign policy that decides to deal with strength with countries, but not planning to internally manipulate their economies or crush them. I mean, we need to deal with nation states with some degree of respect. I mean, it's almost like if you go into an area of a city where if you show the gangs some degree of respect, they won't kill you. But if you go in there with a bad attitude, you're going to be attacked by all the gangs jumping on you. And that's what's happening to America. We're going to get jumped on shortly. And that's what basically Putin's saying. I have friends too, America, and my friends have a large chunk of the world economy. And if we pull your House of Cards economy down by just simply not exchanging for dollars and for oil even, I mean, right now there's been deals going on since the Iran crisis the last number of 5 years.
But, you know, just to go back to the Putin question, the fact that the United States is, and by United States I mean Obama and Kerry and McCain on the Republican side, the fact that we're supporting a known group of Nazis to take power by force, convince the Russians that you can't work with Obama.
Right,
so
exactly.
Well,
the same way, well, listen, even the Saudis realized that Al-Qaeda wanted to remove the Saudi princes and King Abdullah from power. They realized they pulled it too. 6 months before we even got the message that maybe that Morsi needed to go, the Saudis said, we're done with these guys.
That's right.
They're dangerous. And even the Saudis, as evil as they are, they knew it was suicidal to continue to support these terrorists.
Well, we've got history on our side. The question is, do we have the American people on our side who can play the LaRouche card the way the Russians are? And again, 800-922-2907. Call us up and join the impeachment fight.
Yeah, I think if we do that, we can avert. We'll hear the whizzing sound of the bullet of World War III go past our ears. And we'll enjoy a nice Christmas and holiday Hanukkah over the end of this year, and we'll have survived. Otherwise, as I say, we won't be meeting you in as they say in some of the prayers in Jerusalem, we'll be meeting you in heaven or hell. It won't be funny. It'll be a mess. Back in a moment with hour number two. Hour three, Deborah Tavares will give you a major update on Italy and Agenda 21 and much more. NASA war documents. Back in a moment. Hour two coming up.